Tomahawk TV News, Montague County's only newscast, coming at you from Nocona High School.
Welcome back, Montague County. This is Senior Morgan Dyer with your news. First up, Kieran Gibbs has reviewed the movie The Night Before in the Movie Dumpster Review.
Welcome to the Movie Dumpster, the segment in Tomahawk TV News where I, Kieran Gibbs, tell you what's worth seeing and what's not.
You look insane. Only your right eye is working.
Do I look weird now?
Yes, you look weird. Still weird. Weirder.
This week I'll be examining the newest Christmas comedy, The Night Before. Now, this film is rated R, so viewer's discretion is advised. The Night Before was written and directed by Jonathan Levine, which is an odd turn for Levine because normally in his films, such as 50-50 and Warm Bodies, he puts a comedy as an undertone and focuses more on the storytelling aspect, as opposed to The Night Before, which focuses on all-out shock value and laughter to get its point across. The film stars Seth Rogen, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, and Anthony Mackie as three best friends who are spending their final Christmas Eve together, Rogen being a producer on the film. The big issue with these kind of movies is that they are either way too much in the shock humor field, such as The Sitter starring Jonah Hill, or too lacking in substance, such as Jeff Who Lives at Home. The Night Before finds the balance between humor and storytelling excellently and results in a good time at the movies. The movie also touches on the theme of abandonment in a humorous way and shows that sometimes all one needs on the holidays are good friends and good times. In short, The Night Before has a dirty mind but a good heart and lives up to the reviews as the funniest movie of Christmas. I give it 4 Tomahawks out of 5. This has been Kieran Gibbs. Happy holidays, and thank you for watching.
Thank you for the review, Kieran. Now, for your music of the week, Christine DeBoard and Alex Sampson have a look into the new artist, Sam Hunt, and Cassidy Prater has the top 5 songs of the week.
Hello, Nocona High School. I'm Christine Wadlow. This week we are talking about an artist that has become very popular over the last few months. This artist puts a twist to good old country music. He doesn't just base his music off of country, he also puts other genres in it, like rap and R&B. That's right, we're talking about Sam Hunt. Sam Hunt did amazing covers over the songs by Kenny Chesney, Come Over, Keith Urban, Cop Car, and Billy Currington, We Are the Tonight. Listen to this mixed clip of all of these songs.
We drove right past that no trespassing sign. Baby, I know it sounds crazy, but there was something about the way the blue lights were shining, bringing out the freedom in your eyes. Come over, come over, come over, come over, come over.
Sam Hunt made a debut when he released the single Raise On It in 2013. Followed by a 15-song demo mixtape called Between the Pines that same year. Hunt signed a record deal with MCA Nashville Records in 2014 and released the single Leave the Night On in that same year and advanced to the number one on country top charts. Sam released the newest album, Monte Vallo, in October. It was number one on country charts and number three on the pop charts. And it generated two additional hits, House Party, which reached number one, and Break Up in a Small Town, which reached number three. Let's listen to a mixed clip of all the songs from his newest album. Thank
you. We'll have a house party. We don't need nobody. Turn your TV off. Break that boombox out. We'll wake up all the neighbors. Fill the whole. Take your time. I don't have to meet your mother. We don't have to cross that line. Get down with somebody I know. I guess that's just how it goes when you break up in a small town.
Hello, Nocona High School. I'm Cassie Prater, and thank you for joining my top 5 trio. I'll be telling you what songs are hot this week on our top 5 for pop, rock, and country music. We're going to start with the top 5 pop songs for this week. Starting in at 5 is Same Old Love by Selena Gomez. At 4 we have Confident by Demi Lovato. At 3, we have Love Yourself by Justin Bieber. And number 2, we have Sorry by Justin Bieber. And at number 1, we have Hello by Adele.
Hello, can you hear me? Hello from the other side. I must have called 1,000 times to tell you I'm sorry for everything that I've done.
Our rock this week is, starting at 5, is Benny and the Jets by Elton John. At 4, we have Drops of Jupiter by Train. At 3, we have In the Air Tonight by Phil Collins. At 2, we have Picture by Kid Rock featuring Sheryl Crow. And number 1, we have SOB by Nathaniel Rateliff and The Night Sweats. For our good old country this week, we have, starting at 5, is Burning House by Cam. At 4, we have Tennessee Whiskey by Chris Stapleton. At 3, we have Break Up in a Small Town by Sam Hunt. And at 2, we have Die a Happy Man by Thomas Rhett. And at number 1, we have I Love That I Hate You by Kane Brown.
Come the love that I hate you. I can't stop thinking about the time that you're not here. It's going on without you. Hasn't been so bad. It's the best time of the year. Girl, I love that I hate you.
I want to thank you guys for watching this week's Tomahawk Moment for Music, and we will see you next week.
Thank you for the story, guys. Alex Perez is introducing his newest Indian insight for the week.
Hello, Nakona High School, and welcome to Indian Insight with me, Alex Perez. Next week on the show, we take a look into a class that has some of the most interesting hands-on teaching, the Ag class. We'll be talking to some of the students of the class, like William Barnett, a student who does not shy away from hands-on work. Ozzie Delgado, a student that has the experience and the skill to know his way around the welder. And Dawson Acuna, someone who is willing and eager to learn. We will also be speaking to the teacher of the class, Mr. Shipman, to get some inside information of what is taught in the Ag class and how he does it. So join us next week when Indian Insight takes on the Ag class. See you there.
I can't wait to hear more about the Ag classes and all they do. Macy Milton has your latest forecast for the week.
Hello, and welcome to this week's Tomahawk Weather. I'm Macy with your report. This week, temperatures will stay in the 60s as we head to the second week of December. The rain from the past couple of weeks will come to a stop, and skies will be mostly sunny with a few occasional clouds. The chance for precipitation is low. Wind will stay fairly light for the first part of the week, but could pick up towards the weekend. For those who enjoy a white winter season, this season could definitely please. In the past, strong El Niños, much like the one the United States is experiencing, bring more precipitation and drier atmospheres, which could mean more snow. But there are very few El Niños of this caliber to compare, so anything could happen. This has been your weekly Tomahawk Weather. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you back next week.
Thank you, Macy. The students at Nocona High School have been participating in a can drive the past few weeks and ended it the day before Thanksgiving break. The canned foods that the students collected were donated to the local hand-up organization in Nocona. They hoped to provide many families with Thanksgiving dinners with the food provided by the canned food drive. Thank you to all of the students that were a part of this generous act of kindness. Up next, Cole Jackson has your weekly sports report on the local and national sports teams.
Hello, Nocona High School. I'm Cole Jackson, and welcome to this week's edition of Tomahawk Sports. In local sports news this week, before the break, the Lady Indians and Indians played Petrolia at home. The Lady Indians won, but the Indians lost a hard-fought game. The Lady Indians played in the Valley View Tournament this past weekend, while the boys played in the Lake Worth Tournament. In national sports news, the Dallas Cowboys got Tony Romo back, won a game, gave fans a little bit of hope, then completely destroyed it on Thanksgiving against the Carolina Panthers. To top it all off, Tony Romo fractured his clavicle again, and this time he's out for the season. This year was a big bust for the once hopeful Dallas Cowboys. The Houston Texans have been pulling off a season comeback and recently just beat the New Orleans Saints. The undefeated Patriots also lost, making many football fans happy. After much speculation of whether or not Les Miles would be fired by season's end, it turned out that he wasn't fired after the Tigers' last regular season game. The LSU AD said Miles is and will be their football coach. Fellow SEC coach Mark Richt of Georgia didn't get the same treatment. He was fired the day after the Bulldogs' last game. The Golden State Warriors are still making an incredible undefeated run to start the season. Now here's this week's in the top four in the Tomahawk Sports College Football Rankings. Coming in at number four, we have Oklahoma. At number three, we have Iowa. At number two, we have Alabama. And at number one, we still have Clemson. Oklahoma recently won the Big 12, but didn't play in a championship game on Championship Saturday. It's up in the air if the playoff committee will put them in, especially with their awful loss to Texas. That's it for this week in sports. I hope you have a great week. Once again, I'm Cole Jackson, signing off for Tomahawk Sports.
Thank you for the news, Cole, and good luck to all of the basketball teams this season. The crew at the Weekly Viral has this week's top internet sensations to share with you.
Welcome to the Weekly Viral Review, in which we tell you what has been recently trending on the internet. I'm Connor Barrett.
And I'm Jocelyn Wadlow.
And to join our underground fight club, text this number right here. There's only like three of us, so it's kind of weird.
Sam and Colby on Vine recently posted a video of the things people tend to do when they get scared.
So is it any wonder people are afraid of equality?
Equality!
You know what I'm scared of?
What?
Dolls. Porcelain dolls. They're really creepy. You look kind of like a messed up porcelain doll. Like they cooked you in the oven too long. On Vine, Lily Pond showed us the benefits of having guy friends.
Hey guys, can you help me pick? Also
on Vine, David Lopez posted a video of why you should finish your vegetables.
You really need to finish your vegetables.
Why?
So you can get big and strong.
You can get big and strong.
You like that?
I don't like vegetables.
I don't like you. You look like a potato. Bro Science on YouTube is showing us the best fitness page ever.
I'm Don Mazzetti, and this is Bro Science. 50% fact, 50% magic, 100% results.
Fitness, like spend this whole bag of Sour Patch Kids in my mouth? On Twitter, @StuAthleteProblems posted a video of bench goals.
Good God.
The drive, the dish, and the dunk.
Our adorable animal video of the week comes from Jennifer Pratzer of a baby goat copying people.
You look like a baby goat.
You smell like a goat. An old, nasty goat. Nasty. Well, that's it for this weekly viral review. And remember to come to high school. You're kind of a big deal.
Thanks, guys. Zach Boyd is here taking more questions, but this week has a little help from Connor Barrett.
Hey guys, and welcome back to Just Ask Zach. I'm your host, Zach Boyd, but you should know that by now.
Zach, chill out. You look like a discount G-Eazy.
Oh yeah, the joke's on you. I was going for that look. Our first question comes from @Desi_Ray17 asks, do penguin eggs come from penguins or gins that are in pens? All right, I'm going to need you to slow those questions down
They make him a lot smaller and dumber because I have the mind of a 5-year-old.
He struggles with normal questions.
Yeah. Our next question comes from @Pippilicious15 asks, can I take your picture to prove to all my friends that angels really do exist? Are you sure you're not getting me and Connor mixed up? Because Connor is the beautiful man here.
Thanks. And
no problem. This next question comes from @BigZ7099 asked, who put the alphabet in alphabetical order?
Zach, do you even know your ABCs?
Yeah.
Okay, say them. Real quick, just say them.
A, B,
C. Okay, that's enough. You're good.
Our next question comes from @TheGiveMeister16 asked, if there are 7 gnomes on a rooftop running counterclockwise at 7 meters per second, what is the mass of the Earth's sun? All right, Miss Odeno. I didn't know that you were going to start sending in questions. So next week I'll be prepared because I don't know what the answer to that is. Our next question comes from @ConnorBarrett4 asks, what's up with the Nazi haircut? Just stop. No.
Did you just say Gestapo?
Oh, no.
You said Gestapo.
Maybe. Shut up, Connor. This next question comes from the ginger herself, @MorganDyer, asked, if common sense was all that common, wouldn't we all have it? I don't know. If all people were gingers, would we still hate them?
I would.
I wouldn't, because I love everyone.
Except for gingers.
Yeah, maybe a little bit. Our next question comes from @BradenSkinner, asked, where did you get your fade from? I don't know. You buying?
Buying what?
Exactly. All right, guys, that's it for this segment of Just Ask Zach. Please send in more questions at Twitter and Instagram at #JustAskZach. And I'll see you next week, ladies and gentlemen. Woo!
Thank you for the answers, guys. Remember to submit all of your questions to Just Ask Zach on Twitter and Instagram. This week, some students at Nocona High School were inducted to the prestigious National Honor Society. To get more on this, Sabrina Matthews interviewed some more inductees.
Hi, my name is Sabrina Matthews with Tomahawk TV News. The National Honor Society is the nation's premier organization established to recognize outstanding high school students. More than just an honor roll, NHS serves to recognize those students who have demonstrated excellence in the areas of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. These characteristics have been associated with the membership in the organization since its beginning in 1921. Today we have with us Ms. Perkey, who is the National Honor Society advisor here at Nocona High School. Ms. Perkey, what does a student have to do to get accepted into NHS?
First off, a student has to qualify based off their GPA. Then second, once they qualify, we have an informal meeting where the students go through and see what the application process is. While they fill out the application, they are talking about themselves, their leadership, their character, their extracurricular activities, along with any community service that they've done. And once that application's filled out, then it goes to a committee where it's evaluated, and then they are given an acceptance or letter sent in the mail.
Desiree, were you excited when you found out you were part of the National Honor Society?
Yes, I was actually really nervous whenever I first got the letter because it seemed like everybody else got theirs, and I hadn't got mine yet in the mail. And whenever it finally did come, my mom, she opened it, and she wouldn't let me read it until my dad did. And so then I was really nervous because I didn't know what it said. But then she finally gave it to me, and I read it, and I got accepted. And yeah, it was really cool. I'm excited.
Jocelyn, were you excited when you found out you're part of the National Honor Society?
I was actually really nervous because I didn't know if I was going to get in, because a lot of my friends had already gotten their letters. But then the day that I got it, my dad and mom already knew. And so my mom had to read it to me, and I remember running around my house screaming because I was so happy about it.
How many students were inducted this year?
This year we currently inducted 22 students. We had 17 from the previous year, so the chapter this year will be 39 students.
And were you in the National Honor Society when you were in high school?
I actually was. I was in the National Honor Society for Fridley, Minnesota my junior year.
Thank you for letting me in.
The high purpose of the National Honor Society.
The high purpose of the National Honor Society.
Striving in every way.
Striving in every way.
By word and deed.
By word and deed.
To make its ideals.
To make its ideals.
The ideals of my school.
The ideals of my school.
And of my life.
And of my life.
Thank you. You may be seated.
This has been Sabrina Matthews with Tomahawk TV News coming at you from Nakona High.
Thank you, Sabrina, and congratulations to all of the students that were inducted. Trayton and Austin with the Country Kids Consumer Reports have a look inside a program here at Nakona High School.
We mud bogging, you stuck watching, wishing you can be with us cause the party popping. You say you can dig, man, we ain't seen nothing. Your girl wanna be with us, now I heard she said she want a mud digger.
Welcome to another episode of Country Kids Consumer Report with Trayton and Austin. This week we'll be talking about wheels. I bought these wheels off a buddy of mine. They're 22-inch Decenti gloss black wheels. Retailed around $1,200.
This is Dylan's truck. He's behind the camera. But he put some Dodge factory SRT 10 wheels on his single cab. They're 20-inch wheels by 9s. They're just stock, regular Dodge wheels, just the SRT version.
Thanks for tuning in for another episode of the Country Kids Consumer Report. Tune in next week.
Thank you guys for the segment, and thank you Monte County for tuning in. We will see you back here next week.
Tomahawk TV News, Monte County's only newscast, coming at you from Nakona High School.